When Emma Coronel Aispuro watched her husband, the dreaded drug kingpin Joaquin El Chapo Guzman, being sentenced to life imprisonment by a Brooklyn federal court, she looked unfazed. The former Mexican beauty queen was just 29 and 32 years younger than her 61-year-old husband. Although Aispuro was married to the world's most notorious drug boss, she lived mostly in obscurity. But as soon as El Chapo went to jail, it turned out Aispuro lived quite a lavish lifestyle and did not stop her luxurious spending until her own arrest in 2021. Aispuro was arrested in Dulles International Airport on charges of helping her husband in his illegal activities and even assisting his escape. Even as husband and wife may spend jail time together, take a look at the life of El Chapo's wife and her extravagant lifestyle. She married El Chapo when she was just 18. Emma Coronel Aispuro was only 18 when she married the 47-year-old Guzman. She was called the Narco Princess and the daughter of a rich rancher who grew opium poppy and marijuana. Coronel Barreras was a Sinaloa cartel lieutenant who was convicted and later sentenced to prison for drug trafficking and firearms. Her uncle was drug kingpin Ignacio Nacho Coronel, one of El Chapo's most trusted men. Coronel held dual citizenship since she was born in San Francisco, California, while her mother was visiting relatives there. Coronel was then raised in the small village of La Angostura, Durango, Mexico. When El Chapo met her after she was crowned queen of the coffee and guava festival in the Mexican state of Durango, he immediately wanted to make her his wife. It is believed the drug dealer, then 47, had a hand in the event that ensured Emma won first prize. The pair married later that same year on the teenager's 18th birthday. She lived a sheltered and unobscured married life. Coronel lived a relatively sheltered and protected life up until El Chapo was convicted in a trial that drew international attention. Even after her marriage, like all narco wives, she was kept out of media attention. In 2012, she gave birth to twins, in Maria Joaquina and Emily Guadalupe, where she traveled indiscreetly to a hospital in Lancaster, California, north of Los Angeles. She left the father's name blank on the children's birth certificates to protect El Chapo's identity. She became known as the Narco Barbie. After El Chapo's conviction, Aispuro became a celebrity overnight in Mexico. She has given several interviews after El Chapo was extradited and sent to the U.S. in 2019. Even though his sentence included forfeiting his $12.6 billion fortune, it hardly made an impact on Aispuro's lifestyle, who has been constantly in the news for her purchases, parties, and spending. After El Chapo's conviction, she became a celebrity on social media, and she even contemplated launching her own fashion line. Suddenly, it seemed Aispuro was given a new lease on life, with photos showing her on vacation and showing off her Prada purses. Later in 2019, she appeared in VH1 reality show Cartel Crew, where she filmed a scene with the son of a Colombian drug lord on a yacht. Her lavish lifestyle has even angered the Sinaloa cartel. Her actions during and after her husband's trial angered many in the cartel, saying she had violated the unwritten rules about family and wives especially, keeping a low profile. Emma had largely remained anonymous like all partners of Sinaloa cartel capos, but she gradually transformed, taking on a celebrity status which was seen as breaking the tradition of secrecy by the leadership of the Sinaloa cartel. While El Chapo was facing the prospect of spending his life behind bars, Emma was enjoying an extravagant and opulent lifestyle, filled with vacations to exotic destinations, over-the-top parties, expensive designer clothes and handbags, among which her favorite was Prada. She became an Instagram star. Coronel became one of the most trending personalities on Instagram, which in no way reflected the actions of a kingpin of the famous cartel. Emma chalked up 50,000 followers, and clearly El Chapo's associates were not happy. Emma even made an appearance on a reality show dedicated to the families of drug traffickers. Her last photo on Instagram was posted in December, where she wore a white wedding dress. On her birthday in July, she posted a photo looking resplendent in red lipstick, a black leather jacket, and a crown in her long dark hair, reflecting her beauty queen look with a tagline, "Happy birthday to me." Her mother worried about her lifestyle. Mexican investigative journalist Anabel Hernandez, quite an authority on the Sinaloa cartel, even disclosed how a source told her that Coronel's mother, Blanca Aispuro, was worried about the turn her daughter's life was taking. She was worried that Emma could be harmed by other cartels because she was now unleashed. She lived life out on the street, she visited nightclubs every day, and lived an excessive social life. To top it all off, she posted her lifestyle unabashedly on Instagram for all to see. Her mother worried she could become a target of the government. Many alleged that Coronel had some inkling about where El Chapo had stashed away his billions, and she was using blood money to fund her lifestyle. Others felt her flamboyant and no-holds-barred new display of luxury was revenge against her husband's affairs. She showed up at her husband's trial wearing a new designer suit every day. Like all devoted wives, Coronel affirmed she was one too, by becoming a constant fixture at the Brooklyn courthouse. She was seen in a designer suit every day, but would sit stony-faced as her husband was being charged with 17 crimes, leading the extremely dangerous Sinaloa drug cartel, and transporting at least 200,000 kilos of cocaine to the U.S. from Mexico. When Coronel would enter the courtroom with her designer wardrobe, photographers elbowed each other to capture her arrivals and departures. She would stride around the courtroom chatting amicably with reporters and even offering them cookies. At one time, she even brought her 7-year-old twin daughters, dressed in matching jeans and white jackets. She was seen smiling after leaving his trial. While she was attending the trial, Coronel lived in the swanky Tillery Hotel in Brooklyn, which was anything but solidarity with her husband, who lived in a cell. Some felt Coronel's lifestyle was in revenge for learning about her husband's many mistresses. As journalist Hernandez remarked, it was a way of taking revenge by making her husband see what he was losing. After the trial, Guzman received a life sentence plus an additional 30 years in July 2019. He was also ordered to forfeit more than $12.6 billion. He is currently serving his time at a federal supermax prison facility in Colorado. As a woman whose husband has just received a life sentence, Coronel never really showed much of a reaction. In fact, she just went back to her lavish life, throwing a huge birthday party for her daughters soon after. She threw a lavish birthday party for her daughters after El Chapo was convicted. Coronel's lavish spending turned many heads, but the high point was when she threw a huge Barbie-themed birthday party for her 7-year-old twin daughters, Emily and Maria. The party featured several huge arches made of pink balloons and a variety of Barbie paraphernalia. She hired a complete ballroom with a chandelier that was redecorated to look like a pink Barbie dreamhouse, complete with candy, pink cakes, and a large Barbie neon sign. Some Mexicans were infuriated after reading the news on social media accusing her of using blood money from her husband's 61-year-old drug empire. Her actions even attracted the DEA, where one agent once commented to the New York Post saying she would go around flaunting her wealth in everyone's face. Coronel claimed she had no idea about El Chapo's business. When Coronel married El Chapo in 2007, her father, Ines Coronel Barreras, was allegedly in charge of moving the Sinaloa cartel's marijuana across the border into Arizona. In 2013, he was arrested with one of his sons and other men in a warehouse, with guns and hundreds of pounds of marijuana across the border from Douglas, Arizona. Surprisingly, though, in several interviews, Coronel says that she had no idea her husband was a drug trafficker. She claimed El Chapo was an ordinary guy who was very intelligent, despite not having any schooling. Yet he learned from the knocks in life. She also went on to claim how her husband's fame was because of the constant media attention, blaming journalists for sensationalizing claims about his involvement in dealing narcotics illegally. "If I had known something, I wouldn't have been able to sleep or eat from desperation," she said. "I had no idea." She started her own fashion line. In 2019, Coronel launched her own fashion brand in the United States, bearing her husband's name, El Chapo Guzman, which is crazy indeed. Apparently, in an agreement signed by the couple after his conviction, Coronel has the image rights to his name after the Metropolitan Correctional Center in Manhattan allowed him to do so. The fashion line also includes sportswear with the name El Chapo Sports, and casual wear featuring El Chapo baseball caps and denim jackets. Coronel's fashion accessories also included sporting luxury bags and designer clothing. She was soon noticed by the U.S. authorities. Coronel's lifestyle was just not satiated. Her luxurious living finally attracted the attention of U.S. authorities, who suspected she was somehow involved with El Chapo's illegal activities in more ways than one, although she was playing dumb. During the trial of El Chapo, one of his former lieutenants even testified how Coronel was instrumental in helping her husband escape the first time he was captured from Mexico's Altiplano prison on July 11, 2015. It was Coronel who relayed the messages between the drug lord and his sons, ultimately escaping via a mile-long underground tunnel from his cell to the outside with an electric motorbike track. After his rearrest, she was also accused of planning his second escape in January 2017. She was soon arrested in 2021. Coronel soon found it hard to keep up the charade of not knowing about El Chapo's drug trafficking. What finally did her in was her own unabashed life that attracted loads of publicity, showing her soaking up the sun on beaches, attending social events in her stilettos and designer wear, all the while claiming how she was a good wife, while El Chapo was the model husband who loved her. The glamour queen, or narco Barbie as many called her, had her life of luxury turned upside down when she was finally arrested on February 22, 2021, at Dulles International Airport. Sources have said it was Coronel who returned to the USA to give herself up, in hopes of reaching a settlement. She was charged with conspiracy to unlawfully import and distribute illegal drugs into the U.S., and of helping her husband escape from prison. Police sources have revealed how they hope she will now turn around and reveal evidence on her husband's associates, including his 15 sons, who are all believed to be running the bloodthirsty Sinaloa cartel in their father's absence. Coronel herself faces 10 years to life in prison, and a fine of up to $10 million U.S. If you liked this video, why not watch the next amazing one soon after? but don't forget to click on the notification and subscribe to The Drop.